Hi everyone, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. Today we'll be doing a GTS 2 mini accuracy test for heart rate accuracy. But this is not the usual heart rate accuracy test. This is actually a test that was done while I was having a leg workout in the gym. So this is different to the dynamics of the heart rate while you're running, while you're on the treadmill, or while you're cycling. This is a gym workout, and actually not anything in the arms that's close to the heart. No, it's a leg workout where you're pumping, when you're breathing hard, and when sweat breaks out quite easily. So this was a 25-minute workout, full on. Anyway, let's get into this accuracy test. So before we get into the actual numbers, let's talk about the GTS 2 Mini. Just to give you a round off picture about this great smartwatch. So this smartwatch is actually from Amazfit, from Huami Amazfit. And this is the cheapest smartwatch in the Amazfit smartwatch range. So as we know, in the fitness trackers, there's the Amazfit Band 5, which is the classic or slimline fitness tracker. Then of course, there's the BIPU, which is more square, it's got a thick lower lip, and it's an LCD display. And then we've got the smartwatch range. So first up is the GTS 2 Mini. So it's got an aluminium case, it's got an AMOLED display, it's got a lot of features. Then of course we've got the GTR and the GTS 2e, and then the flagships, which are the GTR 2 as well as the GTS 2. Now the GTR is the round one, the GTS is the rectangular one. But let's get back to the GTS 2 Mini. So with the GTS 2 Mini, it's cheap. When I say cheap, I really mean that. It costs almost half price from the all new Fitbit Lux, which is a fitness tracker from Fitbit. Now this one here, aluminium case, 1.5 inch AMOLED display. It's crisp, it's bright. There are 70 sport modes. It's got inbuilt dual GPS. It tracks your sleep in three sleep stages. So your light, your deep, and REM sleep. It's got stress monitoring as well as continuous stress monitoring. It can do your SpO2, oxygen blood saturation. Yes, it's a spot reading, not continuous, but nonetheless it's there. It's got continuous heart rate monitoring. It's got a music player, but unfortunately it doesn't have any allocated storage for your music. That's a bit of a downside, but nonetheless you're getting all that for £79 or $80. That is a very sharp price. And it's got a world clock, it's got a Pomodoro tracker, it's got a compass, it's got a lot of the features and functions that you would expect from a premium. It's got a breathing app, it's got a weather widget, it can do all the basic things like your timer, stopwatch, it's got a silent alarm, all the rest of it. You can actually have an always on display. There are lots and lots of faces that you can download from the Zep app. Now, this is all about the actual smartwatch. Let's get into the numbers, because from what we've seen on the previous test when I was running or cycling, the GTS 2 Mini is one of the most accurate smartwatches with one of the best optical heart rate sensors that we've seen on a smartwatch. And not just a budget smartwatch. We're talking about all the tests that we've done on the WesKnows Tech News and Reviews channel. This smartwatch here brings in results that are so close to our benchmark, and that's the Polar H10 ECG chest strap, which is always on my chest when I'm working out or cycling or running or whatever it is. Now, the Polar H10 is considered to be the most accurate ECG chest strap on the market. It's used by scientists as well as researchers and professional athletes alike because of its highly accurate results. Well, this bad boy here is so close, it almost tracks it. So this optical heart rate sensor on the back of this cheap smartwatch is actually very good. But now we've taken it to the test with a leg workout. This is not the same dynamics as having your heart rate plotted from when you're running or cycling. Anyways, let's get into the numbers. Let's see what the Polar H10 has come up with, and then we'll take a look at what the Amazfit GTS 2 Mini has to showcase. Let's do it. So first of all, let's take a look at the numbers from the Polar H10. And what we can see there is that the average heart rate was actually registered at 124 beats per minute, while the max was registered at 139 beats per minute. So we can see that even though the workout was rather compact, I was sweating, I was working hard, but still the heart rate just didn't get up there. Probably it's the rest times that you get between sets. But anyway, let's take a look now at what the Amazfit GTS 2 Mini has actually registered. And what we can see is that the heart rate, the average heart rate, was registered at 125 beats per minute. That's less than a 1% variance. Now, the max was registered at 140 beats per minute. So again, just under 1%. Well, in fact, it's about 0.6% of a variance. That's amazing results. This is pretty much as good as it can get for an optical heart rate sensor to basically track your every 1 second readings from the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. Anyways, I hope you did find this accuracy test of the GTS 2 Mini useful, in that it does help you make up your mind when you're going out to make a purchase. Now, if you are going to make a purchase of a GTS, now if you are going out there to buy a GPS smartwatch, do consider this, that even though it does have inbuilt GPS, it doesn't have any allocated storage for music. And that would mean that if you're going out for a long run or a long cycle, you will still have your smartphone with you for the media downloads, right? Or streaming music. You can't do it off the watch simply because there's no allocated storage. It's just got GPS. Now, it's good, but again, it's not going to help you if you're going on those long runs and cycles. You will still have your smartphone with you. But anyways, thank you for watching this accuracy test. If you did find it useful, please drop us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, you know what to do. Please hit the red subscribe button below the video. And we'll see you in the next one.